Five tips to help you guys enjoy drop shotting more, get more bites on that little drop shot bait, and land more of those fish that bite that little drop shot hook. That's what this video is going to be focused on. That's what we're going to talk about, is how to be more effective drop shot fishing for giant smallmouth bass. Now, if you guys are brand new to the channel, if this is your introduction to who I am, my name is Benjamin Nowak. This is the Smallmouth Experience, a smallmouth bass fishing focused YouTube channel. And I would really appreciate it if you guys considered subscribing to the channel and growing this community. So what made me want to film this video for you guys? What was my driving force behind talking to you guys about this? Well, one, I want to break the stigma around drop shot fishing. I want to give you guys some information that'll make you guys enjoy this technique more. I'm also going on a fishing trip this weekend, going away for 2 days to a part of the state that I've never visited. And I know a drop shot's going to come into play, so it's something I want to talk to you guys about. Now, this is not an all-inclusive drop shot video. I'm not going to go into baits. I'm not going to go into here's why, when, how to do it. But what we're going to be talking about are 5 tips to help you guys be more successful with this. Without further ado, let's dive into tip number 1. Drop shot fishing does not have to be boring. So one of the biggest misconceptions about a drop shot is you have to cast it out, drag it along the bottom, and wait for a fish to bite. That is not the way that I drop shot fish. I think that's a way to waste a day. That's a way to really get bored with this technique quickly. So what I do is I target fish. That means I'm looking for areas where I know smallmouth bass are living. I'm looking for high percentage areas. I'm looking for boulders. I'm going to go through an area where I know fish are living with a drop shot, because it gets a lot of bigger bites from fish that are lethargic, or those bigger fish that won't bite moving baits or reaction baits or faster moving bottom baits. But something just kind of dragging through looking supernatural like a drop shot is a great way to get those fish to bite. Target fish with a drop shot. That will help you guys enjoy this more and get more bites in areas where you know fish are living. Tip number 2, matching your leader length to the depth of water that you're fishing. Now, this is something I've played around with a lot lately. I've been fishing a lot of deeper water, fishing 27 to 30 foot of water, but then I've also been mixing it up, going into that 10 foot range where these fish are living around grass, and changing up your leader length will give you an opportunity to really maximize your efforts with the drop shot. Now, if you guys can see this, I posted a picture on my Instagram, and this is basically the entire setup. Okay, so I have about a 24 to 28 inch leader on this drop shot. Super, super long leader, but I'm fishing in 27 foot of water. So why does that matter? Well, a lot of times that's gonna allow your bait to kind of suspend higher in the water column, not necessarily way up. I mean, it's not gonna be super suspended. You're only about 2 foot off the bottom, which when you think about it, is not that far. But in that deeper water situation, that smallmouth can typically see your bait from a longer distance. They can come over to it. It's gonna look more natural. And it's gonna give those fish a little bit more opportunity to find your bait, because it's gonna be off the bottom and look super natural. A general rule of thumb for you guys is the deeper water you're fishing, go to a longer leader length. And as you get in shallower water, kind of shorten that leader, but also play around with it. Don't be afraid to run a 2 foot leader in 12 foot of water. Just kind of keep an open mind, play with the leader length and see how the fish react to it. Another consideration is that when you're fishing shallower water but you're casting that drop shot away from the boat, even if you have a 2 foot leader, your bait is not 2 foot off the bottom. The further away that bait is from you, the closer it is to the bottom, because you're dragging that bait at an angle, so your leader is now at an angle as well. So if you have a 2 foot leader, your bait might only be 10 inches off the bottom. So kind of keep those things in consideration. Look at the depth you're fishing, look at what those fish are doing on the bottom, how close they are to the bottom, and also keep into consideration, smallmouth are gonna be traveling a long distance to get this thing. So don't be afraid to run a really long leader. I think that's something that can differentiate you, especially when you're fishing around a lot of other guys that are fishing a drop shot. Tip number 3, match your weight to not only the depth that you're fishing, the cover that you're fishing, and the style or aggressiveness of these fish. So what that means is typically I'm using the lightest weight that I can get away with to keep that bait or maintain bottom contact. I want to get that bait down close to bottom and maintain bottom contact. That's going to essentially give you the best action out of your drop shot bait. The reason for that is if you put this bait on bottom and you're using a light weight and your boat is bouncing, your bait's gonna have natural movement. There's not gonna be a weight that's pulling down all the time, keeping this thing super straight away from the boat. But if you use a lighter weight, the bait can move a little bit more freely, it can have a lot more natural action. However, the times that I'm gonna go away from this, the times that I'm gonna use that heavier weight, is gonna depend on the aggressiveness of the fish. If I'm fishing around really aggressive smallmouth, where when I drop it on their heads, they bite it right away, I'm okay going with a half, a 3/4, a 1 ounce drop shot weight. Just get it down, get it in front of them, especially if I'm looking at it on the trolling motor. I'm not afraid to go to a 1 ounce weight, 3/4 ounce weight, and drop it on them, bomb it on them, hit it on the head, and get them to react to that bait. So kind of keep into consideration not only the depth you're fishing, the cover you're fishing, but also the aggressiveness of the fish that you're fishing for. That weight is going to play a big factor in the action of your bait, your ability to fish it effectively, and the number of bites that you are getting. Now we're going to talk about some things that will help you land more of those bites when you actually get them. Now, the first thing we're gonna talk about is the reel size and reel speed. This is something I'm very, very adamant on, is using a high speed gear ratio, larger spooled reel. I am using a 30 size Abu Garcia Zeta reel. It's a little bit bigger size, but it has a faster gear ratio. The reason this is important is that it picks up line more quickly. Using a faster gear ratio, higher gear ratio reel will pick up line more quickly than your slower gear ratio. So that's gonna help you keep contact with that fish. When that fish bites, the first thing you want to be able to do is pick up that slack, because a lot of times when you're drop shot fishing, those fish just seem to come up and want to jump right away. Keeping with a high speed gear ratio reel will help you keep up with that fish to maintain contact with them so they don't have any slack, any play, any give in your setup here to get them to the boat. Another thing with the bigger spool is you're gonna be able to manage your line better. If you guys watch some of my drop shot videos, I drop that bait straight down or I make a cast, I want that thing to fall as fast as it possibly can. Even if I'm using a 1/4 ounce weight, a 3/8 ounce weight, I want it to fall as quickly as possible. Using a larger spool is gonna help that line come off the spool better. It's gonna help it get down to the bottom faster, and it could mean the difference between 10 bites, 5 bites, or 0 bites throughout the day. And finally, tip number 5, we're gonna be talking about using the right rod. This is something that my buddy William Daniels called me out on super, super hard for, I believe 2 years ago. I was using a super, super fast rod, and what I mean by that is a rod that unloads super quickly. Getting into a rod breakdown really quickly without going too in-depth, there are 3 things you have to consider when purchasing a rod: length, power, and action. The first is length. Length, I typically like something between 7 foot and 7'2". I don't like to go shorter. I like to have the extra leverage of a longer rod to be able to get a good positive hook set into that fish, and have a longer rod is gonna give me the ability to fight that fish a little bit more effectively when he's further away from the boat. The second thing is the power. That is the stiffness of the rod. That is basically the amount of power or pull you have on that fish when the rod is fully loaded into the blank. When that rod is bent over fully, that is the power. I typically like something medium light, medium. I'm not going to a true medium light. I want something more of that medium light power in my drop shot rod. And the third characteristic of a rod you have to consider is rod action. And this is probably the most overlooked factor when purchasing a rod, myself included. What rod action is how quickly or how deep into the rod your rod is gonna bend. So if you have a extra fast action rod, you're gonna have just the tip of that rod bend. If you have a fast action, you'll bend a little bit further down the blank. A moderate action is going to bend even further down the blank. So basically, I'll throw a chart up here. It's going to determine the amount of the rod that bends and unloads when you're fighting a fish. In the past couple of years, I've been fishing a custom built rod. I thought to myself, use a 7'2", which is the length that I like, use a medium, which is the power that I like, and the action was extra fast. What that means is that rod would unload super quickly. In my brain, that translated to sensitivity. The problem was, that's not the case. Rod action has nothing to do with sensitivity. Sensitivity has to do with the components that a rod is built out of. So using an extra fast rod with a drop shot is not a smart thing, because when that fish surges on you, when that fish jumps, your rod's gonna unload really quickly. That's gonna give you guys a lot of slack in your line. It's gonna cause a lot of fish to come off. I lost a lot of really big fish because I was fishing the extra fast rod and I had no give when I was fighting those fish. And the rod that I'm fishing now is a 7'1" medium light, moderate fast, or fast action. It runs a little bit more like a medium. It's in between a moderate fast and a fast action, and what that means is that it unloads a little bit more slowly for me, so I can play these fish a lot more effectively. When that fish surges, my rod unloads slower, and so this is something that you really have to consider. If I were going to give you guys a tip on drop shot fishing, I would go with something between a 6'9" and a 7'2" medium or medium light, fast or moderate fast action. Do not go with an extra fast drop shot rod. I preached this for a long time, but I was wrong. Go with something more fast or moderate fast. It's gonna unload a little bit slower. It's gonna give you guys a lot more play in the rod. So your rod's gonna absorb a lot of that surge from that fish, keep those fish pinned up, and you're gonna land a lot more smallmouth when they come out to jump. That way you don't end up with a drop shot on your shoulder, because that is never ever fun. So with that said, those are the 5 tips that I have on drop shot fishing to help you guys hopefully enjoy drop shotting more by using it as a target fishing bait, get more bites by watching your leader length and drop shot weight, and land more of those bites that you get by considering the rod and the reel that you're using when you're out there throwing a drop shot. If you guys want to see full inclusive, all-inclusive drop shot fishing videos, you guys can go check out my other drop shot fishing videos. I'll have those linked up in the corner for you guys. But if you have any questions or comments, if you want to talk to me about anything in the comment section, if you have any other tips that I might have missed, hit me up at the comment section down below. If you're not already, please do me a huge favor, hit the subscribe button down below as well. And as always, thank you guys for watching. Take care, tight lines. God bless. Pursue passion.